Good day, I'm Norman Wildberger. We are now starting to talk about algebra in this series on foundational aspects of mathematics. And today we're going to talk about a rather important step up from linear equations, quadratic equations, which have a very long and illustrious history. So the basic problem is something like this. Suppose that we have the equation x squared equals 49. What does x squared mean? It means x times x. Okay? That's called the squaring operation. So we'd like to know what is the solution to this equation. What can x be? Well, if you know your multiplication table, you'll know that 7 times 7 is 49. So there's the solution, x equals 7. But if you think about it for a little while, you'll also realize that, well, minus 7 is also a solution, because minus 7 times minus 7 is also 49. So if we're going to allow negative numbers, and we don't have to, but if we are going to, then there's actually two solutions, x equals 7 and x equals minus 7. Now, for this kind of quadratic equation, knowing what the squares are is very useful. This is something that probably most public school students haven't seen, but it's a good thing for them to see. They don't have to memorize it, but they should have at least seen this table of squares up to a certain amount. So here I've shown you what they all are. Probably from 1 up to 100 it's familiar, maybe 11 squared, 12 squared familiar, but then 13 squared is 169, 14 squared is 196, 15 squared is 225, 16 squared is 256, 17 squared is 289, 18 squared is 324, 19 squared is 361, 20 squared is 400. Those are all useful values to know. But what if we're given a bigger equation like x squared equals 6084? How did I get 6084? Well, I took the number 78 and I squared it. So this is an easy way of generating a quadratic equation. You take some number, you square it, and then you give your friend this equation. Say, well, what is x squared equals blah, 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 your number? You know, because you've taken a number and squared it, but for him to unravel that operation might be a little bit tricky. So we're going to try to think about this this kind of quadratic equation and some more general variants of it. But before we do, let's have a look at some general laws which are very pertinent to understanding quadratic equations. The first is what happens when we square x plus 1. X plus 1 squared, so that's x plus 1 times x plus 1. And if we use the distributive law here, there's an x squared, and there's an x here and another x here for a total of 2x, and then there's also a plus 1. So a very important equation or identity that x plus 1 squared is x squared plus 2x plus 1. And this is important because, first of all, it allows us to generate this table a little bit more efficiently than squaring each individual fellow. For example, suppose we know that 20 squared is 400, and we want to know what is 21 squared. Well, according to this little rule, it's 20 squared plus 2 times 20, which is 40, plus 1. So to go from here to here, we just take this one and we add 2 times the value here, which is 20, and add 1. Similarly, to go from here to here, we take this number, add 2 times that, which it would be 42. We add that, and we get 483, and then we add one more to get 484. That's a somewhat faster way of generating a table like this. And this identity has an important generalization when we replace the 1 with a general y. X plus y all squared. And all students of algebra learn that this is x squared plus 2xy plus y squared. And here we're already seeing a kind of a change in our use of the variables x and y. When I write down this equation, I'm no longer thinking of x and y as unknown quantities. I'm rather thinking of them as representing arbitrary or general numbers. So it's no longer a question of having a look at this and saying, what is x, what is y? X and y are not mystery numbers. This is a general law that applies to any x and any y. It's a slightly different usage of the letters x and y. We'll keep that in mind for later. So here's a more general quadratic equation. X squared plus 10x equals 39. X is some mystery number that satisfies this equation, and I want you to tell me what x is. Well, you can try trial and error, try x equals 1, try x equals 2, and so on, until eventually you'll get it. In this case, it's not too hard. But a general strategy for solving this kind of equation has been known by many cultures. So the ancient Chinese, the Babylonians, the Arabs, the Hindus, they all had an idea of how to solve this kind of equation. And in particular, Al-Khwarizmi, who we've mentioned before, around 800 after Christ, had the following rather nice interpretation. So we think of a L-shaped figure like this, where this has side x, whatever x is, and this has side 5. Here symmetrically x and 5. And we're thinking now about the area of this L-shaped region. Well, there's an x squared here for that square, and each of these rectangles has area 5x. So altogether, the area is x squared plus 10x, because we have two of these guys. So that's exactly the left-hand side. And so now what we do is we think about completing this diagram to a square. In other words, these dotted lines here, we add another portion so that now we have a complete square. Once we've done that, then we have a square whose side is x plus 5. So this total area here will be x plus 5 squared. And that's going to be the area that we started with, which we're assuming is 39, plus the area of the square that we've added. And what is the area of the square that we've added? Well, it's 5 by 5, so this area here is 25. And so x plus 5 squared, the entire area here, is 39 plus 25, which we work out is 64. Now the equation has been transformed from an equation like this to the equation x plus 5 squared equals 64. This is very much like the simpler kind of equation that we've already been talking about, and its solution is x plus 5 equals 8, because 8 times 8 is 64. And from that, we can deduce that x equals 8 minus 5, which is 3. Now there's another solution too, because we could also have chosen minus 8 as the square root of 64. And so there would be another solution here obtained by taking minus 8 minus 5, which is minus 13.